At master level in the tourism domain, we offer you the program of Tourism Destination Management. It's a one-year professional master program, and it's open to students all over the world. Some 40 to 50% of the students come from abroad, so you really enter into an international classroom with 18 to 20 different nationalities. The master program Tourism Destination Management focuses on the subject of the destination, the place where everything happens when it comes to tourism. But it also is a program that allows you to grow, because it's also about your professional growth. So whether you are from a background in economics, in sociology, even people that have studied linguistics, they are welcome in tourism, because we know that tourism destination management is an interdisciplinary world. The master program is built in three phases. The first phase is in Breda, and it starts in September and it ends end of January. So it's 5 months of theory in classroom settings. Since it's a full-time program, you'll be teaching with contact hours between 12 and 14 hours per week in smaller groups as well as individually. You'll get subjects that are related to the complexity of tourism destination management, such as cross-cultural research techniques, destination stakeholder analysis, destination marketing, project management, and destination finance. Also, you'll do national field research. You go to Rotterdam or Amsterdam and try to understand the complexity of tourism in those destinations. In the second phase, you move to Southeast Asia. This period is 3 months. It goes from February until the end of April. You'll visit three different destinations: one city destination, an emerging destination, and a developed destination. In the past, we've always started in Australia, like Melbourne or Brisbane. Then we moved to destinations like Sri Lanka or Cambodia or Myanmar, which is emerging, and we always ended in Bali. The methodology of this field research is really applied research. Everything that you learned in the first phase, you'll apply that in these three destinations, and you'll work in small groups of consulting teams. Once you have finalized your field research project in Southeast Asia, you can do two things. Either you go back in your own national country and you do your thesis research at home, or you come back to the Netherlands and you do your thesis research in the Netherlands. In both cases, you'll get assigned a supervisor that will guide you through the thesis research. The thesis period starts in May and it ends end of August, so it's also about 4 or 5 months. Many students continue the field research and stay 1 month or 6 weeks later and continue to elaborate their thesis in the field before they get back to the Netherlands. It enables them to use the practice that they have had in the second phase and apply that directly in their dissertation research.